going to teach you guys how to make a ledge skatable today using a $12 rub brick from your local Home Depot or Lowe's. Let's do it.
Oh yeah, the rub brick that.
So, you got to have some essentials with you. An extra hat, that's disgusting. Usually don't want to wear it. Shout out to Adam for my bucket with my bag on it. It's the sickest thing ever. This is a rub brick, about 10, 12 bucks, and it's just a piece of concrete with a handle on it. Now what you need is this, in case he's got wax, I hope. I
thought. Yes. Okay.
So,
do. Basically, your broom is going to be your big old duster because it gets pretty dusty.
It's nice when you're in an area that.
Oh, it's shaded too.
Not a lot of people are here because it's pretty loud, and if they get bummed out about you waxing stuff, they're going to be real bummed out about this. But, so what you're going to do, see how it's. There's like a bunch of little ridges, and what they do when they're making the concrete is they take a broom and they wipe it down, and what that does, same with this, if you look, there's like streaks in the concrete, and that, what that's for is like people's shoes to grip, so that it's not just like one sheet of ice when it snows and stuff. So basically what we're gonna do, you're gonna work with a small area first. As you see, it's gonna get real dusty, but what it does is it's gonna smooth everything out and make it real easy to grind, so you don't have like, I don't know, rough concrete, and it's a lot easier to wax it when it's, you know, unsmooth like this. So the smoother the concrete, the easier it is, because you don't have to do it as much. But if it's like this, it's a lot, and it's gonna, you know, have three or four friends with you, because you guys are gonna need to take turns. It gets pretty labor intensive. So what you're gonna do, say you already did this to the whole edge, you're gonna take your broom before you wax it, because it's gonna be real dusty, and the, you know, you're just gonna be waxing dust, and then the wax isn't actually on the ledge. So you wanna take your broom, you wanna get all the dust out of the cracks. Yeah, and then this way you're gonna see the rough edges where you need to keep going.
Work, 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 work.
Alright, so once you've done most of the ledge and you've got it like pretty far out, you want to do also where your wheels are going to go, because if somebody's going to tail slide it and this isn't not grindable, it doesn't really matter about this part. So make sure you want to get this too, and especially on something like this with a little bit of an edge, make sure you get the side right there too. So you want to just do, you know, maybe like an inch or two on this side. So I just normally, and the side's actually already really smooth, which is helpful. But you just want to get like these little things out of the way, and like stuff like that right there, and all these little like lumps and stuff like that. But probably about a good 30 minutes of doing this and you have like a brand new ledge ready to skate. And it helps if you also have like lots of wax.
Oh my God, it's so red.
Okay, so the ledge is done. How long do you think that took us? About 30 minutes? Yeah.
130.
About 30 minutes, you have a brand new ledge, and we could honestly keep going. We could go all the way down if we really wanted to. Look at that.
I wanna get the hole.
Look at that crispiness, look at that. That's how you make a curb, big curb, big curb, skateable. If you guys like this video, we should do how to bondo, because that's a very useful one that you can use in anything. I use it at shred quarters, so it helps not at just skate spots, but at skate parks too. Like, subscribe, hit the thumbs up button, follow my channel with the little thingy, it's right here probably, and we'll see you guys next time. Alex, Casey, you guys have anything to say?
You see it? Don't film me.